Colin Kaepernick has got a powerful message for younger people in his new book. He says, stand up for what you believe in. Now, this comes almost 7 years after the former San Francisco 49ers quarterback started taking a knee during the national anthem to protest racial injustice and police brutality. His new young adult book is called Colin Kaepernick, Change the Game. Details of his coming-of-age journey and his introduction to activism in high school. Adriana Diaz sat down with Kaepernick at a Chicago bookstore for his only TV interview about this book.
Please welcome Colin Kaepernick.
The offseason for Colin Kaepernick looks much different these days. The 35-year-old has a nonprofit.
You're already creating community.
Empowering black and brown youth, a publishing company, and media projects, including a docu-series on Netflix and an upcoming documentary with director Spike Lee. He's also a new father who's spreading a message of empowerment in his new graphic novel, Change the Game. Written with author and University of Chicago professor Eve L. Ewing.
I love how you depict yourself in this book, not as some big shot hero, but as a shy, insecure high schooler like we all were. I mean, I'm speaking for you, but.
Yeah, absolutely.
Growing up, I was I think still am a pretty introverted person. I hope it's true to form, and that's just kind of how I navigate the world.
It's his true high school coming of age story, his journey embracing his blackness, despite resistance from many, including his white adoptive parents.
I know my parents love me, but there were still very problematic things that I went through. I think it was important to show that, no, this can happen in your own home and how we move forward collectively while addressing the racism that is being perpetuated.
He took cues from his icon, basketball star Allen Iverson, who he said wore his blackness like a suit of armor. And teenage Kaepernick wanted cornrows to match. He's getting what roles, his mom asked?
Oh, your hair's not professional. Oh, you look like a little thug.
Your mom said that to you.
Yeah. And those become spaces where it's like, okay, how do I navigate this situation now? But it also is informed why I have my hair long today.
The grown-up version of Eve wanted to go back in time and give young Colin a lot of hugs. And I was really moved and saddened by the level of kind of self-awareness that he had to develop at a very young age without a lot of guidance.
The former NFL quarterback who once led the 49ers to the Super Bowl was known in high school for his baseball. The pitcher even had major league interest, but he bucked public pressure and followed his heart to the gridiron.
There were a lot more black people in football that I was like, I found some community here.
Do you still want to play football professionally?
Absolutely. I woke up this morning before our events, trained 5-6 days a week. Still up at 4:30. I go get my training in. That passion is still there and the ability is still there.
He hasn't played professionally since the 2016-2017 season, when this single gesture sparked both solidarity and outrage.
Why did you choose that day and to protest in that way?
That's actually something we're going to dive deep into with the doc that's coming this fall. But as it relates to the book, people may look at that moment and be like, oh, you must have been this person all along. And it's like, no, there's growth that has to happen.
Will you continue to sit?
Yes.
Then Kaepernick couldn't get hired. And even sued the NFL for collusion in a case that's settled.
Are you talking to any teams?
We reach out to all 32 teams every year throughout the year. Because my biggest thing is, just let me get on the field. If I'm not good enough, cut me. But give me the chance to show you what I can do.
In 2019, the NFL organized a workout for you in hopes of getting you hired. You chose not to go to their workout. You held your own workout. What do you say to people who argue that the NFL did give you a shot?
That's another great question that will be covered in the doc.
In 2020, what did it feel like for you?
Say his name, George Floyd.
To see everyone almost wake up.
Another great question that will be covered later this year.
Colin, I got a lot of great questions.
And I would just say, bitch, fuck you.
So, Colin Kaepernick
want to talk about his parents, the parents who gave him the opportunities to be somebody in life. And he wanna shit on him. But that's what liberals do. He fruity as I don't know what. He's sweet talking his shit. You get me? But I wanna be a thug and all that other stuff. Oh my God. You half white POC. Oh my God. And black women on this interview, I know y'all just wanna, you know, build yourself up and get your name out there and stuff like that. But bro, y'all make us look bad when y'all do shit like this. Believing in this old sorry ass athlete who had every opportunity to be something and turned it down over some bullshit. You get what I'm saying? It's so crazy. You get me? And then you wanna throw in all the clips of Black Lives Matter and all that, like he associated with us. He ain't us, bro. He ain't nothing like us. But y'all, boy, they throw him out there like Eminem, don't he? They throw him out there. You get me? I swear he a plant. He's a plant. Colin Kaepernick has always been a weak-ass plant, bro. Man, that afro ain't fooling nobody, bro. That afro ain't fooling nobody. Man, anyway, man, that's pretty much the video. You don't do your parents like that. If a person do their parents like that, then they'll do you worse. You get me? Liberals don't have no respect for nobody. You get me? They not loyal to nobody. They don't care about nobody but themselves. This interview with Colin Kaepernick was nothing but his way of trying his best to weasel back into the limelight. You get me? You had your chance, man. Leave that mark ass dude to the crows. You get me? I guarantee in a couple years we ain't gonna never even hear nothing about him. But he go try to weasel his way back in with the old Black Lives Matter bullshit. Boy, this makes me so sick. You know, when I see this shit, it makes me sick to my stomach how they play y'all. They play y'all so bad. You get me? They just, man. My. We'll be right back.